Coming up on this edition of Reel to Reel, celebrating youth in the Diocese of Springfield, shooting hoops with the superstars, and Mark Giza reviews some hits and misses. These stories and more are just ahead on Reel to Reel. Hello and welcome to Reel to Reel. It's already midway through January and it seems like we just were talking about World Youth Day 2016 when 70 people from throughout the Diocese of Springfield headed to Krakow, Poland to join thousands of others from around the world in celebrating the Catholic faith. So now there are already plans for World Youth Day 2017. This one will be local, to be held at Our Lady of Fatima Parish in Ludlow this July. A few kickoff events are being held in anticipation of this local celebration, and Carolee McGrath went to one at the Newman Center at the University of Massachusetts at Amherst and has all the info on what's in store in 2017.
On a cold December Friday evening, youth gathered at the Newman Center at UMass to adore Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. Might not be what you think of a typical Friday night at UMass. Then again, these are young people who traveled across an ocean to celebrate their faith and came home on a high like no other.
The way to truly love is to be like Christ. And to me, there is no other perfect way.
24-year-old Seth DeNoyers was one of 70 pilgrims who traveled to Krakow, Poland last summer for World Youth Day. He shared his testimony with other youth from Franklin County at the kickoff to World Youth Day 2017. The event was held at the Newman Center, which included adoration and a social hour to follow. It was designed to promote the World Youth Day to be held in the Diocese of Springfield, July 8th, at Our Lady of Fatima Parish in Ludlow. DeNoyers, who only at the last minute decided to make the World Youth Day pilgrimage, shared his testimony. He explained to the teens gathered that he had fallen away from his faith, but with God's grace, he says, he found his way back.
I tried doing it my own way when I went away from the faith, and it just doesn't work.
Father Peter Salek, parochial vicar at St. Thomas the Apostle Parish in West Springfield, was one of the World Youth Day pilgrims last summer.
An idea came when I came back. I talked to Mrs. Gina Czerwinski, the youth ministry director for the diocese, and to the Bishop Mitchell Ruzhansky, that we have to use it, those exactly the people they went for World Youth Day to Poland for the future, to create something new, and we can do it some meetings like we're doing today to prepare them for Panama in 2019 and also for the Diocesan Day of Youth Days, which is going to take place in July.
Father Salek is working with Gina Czerwinski, the director of youth ministry for the diocese and a World Youth Day pilgrim herself. They're planning three more events to build excitement for the local World Youth Day in July.
The whole day is going to be filled with different speakers and activities and music, prayer experiences. We're hoping to get food from different parishes, different ethnic groups around the diocese from our parishes, so we can have a real international experience.
Our Lady of Fatima Church was chosen as the pilgrimage site because next year will mark the 100th anniversary of the apparitions at Fatima in Portugal. The Blessed Mother appeared to three children six times in 1917, asking them to pray the rosary and to also offer up their suffering for the conversion of sinners. 22-year-old Julia Kozlik, a recent graduate of Regis College in Boston, attended the kickoff and World Youth Day. The registered nurse is a member of Divine Mercy Parish in Three Rivers.
We have been trying to really strengthen our youth programs at my church, and being able to go there to Poland and be among other youth really strengthened that and really kind of invigorated us to come home and bring that same spirit and be able to bring that and share that with the other youth at our church.
Three more gatherings leading up to World Youth Day 2017 will be held in the Springfield Diocese on March 24th at St. Mary Parish in Westfield, April 21st at Divine Mercy Parish in Three Rivers, and May 12th at St. Joseph Parish in Pittsfield. Father Salek says with 2 million people in Poland worshiping Jesus last summer, there is great hope for the future.
It was beautiful. It was excellent. It was a very good experience for everyone, for all of them. Even they slept at the gym floor, but they didn't complain in the end. And I think that was that they were together. You can see that they were together as like the new family, like the new family members of the World Youth Day 2016. Jesus is at work and we have to trust in him like we did in Poland.
And now those who travel to Poland will continue to build on that spiritual momentum as they share their love of Christ in their own communities. Reporting for Reel to Reel, I'm Caroline McGrath.
One more time, keep smiling.
Okay. And we'll certainly be covering that event in July. Now in other youth news, a story about a local parish giving new life to youth ministry. Hannah Green tells us now about how St. Agnes Church in Dalton is creating opportunities for young adults to have a better relationship with God.
If you go to Mass at St. Agnes Parish on Sunday nights, you might see some young faces. That's because at this service, the altar servers, lectors, and praise band members are all under the age of 18. For a decade, St. Agnes Parish has made youth ministry its mission through masses and CCD classes that cater to young adults, and the response has only been positive.
It really involves all ages in the community, which I think is really important, and so it makes me feel more a part of the celebration of Mass when I attend.
This program started more than a decade ago when Father Chris Malatesta arrived at St. Agnes Parish. Father Chris has been involved in youth ministry since his early priesthood, so when he arrived at St. Agnes Parish 13 years ago, he knew exactly what this parish needed, a Mass the youth could call their own. Abby White is a member of the praise band at St. Agnes. She said having a youth Mass helps create community in her church.
I think a lot of the time, the older generations, it feels like you're separate from them, especially in faith, because just of the way our generations are. So when you have people that are the same age as you, it feels more like a community in that sense.
And just like their Mass, these students' religious education is made for young adults.
After Mass, it's less formal CCD class, which makes it easier to get engaged in the classes because it's not traditional, like, here's a textbook, read it, and do the activities in it. It's more the teachers try to make it more incorporated in our everyday life, so it's more personal, which makes it easier to understand.
This youth-focused religious education is through a program called Life Teen Group, which Father Chris brought to St. Agnes 11 years ago. Besides learning in a classroom, the students listen to speakers, attend retreats, and go on social outings. That includes bonding activities like bowling and tubing in the winter. Father Chris said this program was created with 21st century families in mind.
Families are very mobile now, very, very busy. You know, so, and then there's so much media and computers and all sorts of stuff. So when people just come in and sit in a classroom setting, it's not always as engaging, perhaps as, you know, kids are regular things that stimulate them on a daily basis.
And Connor Matthews, a Life Group member, lector, and Camp Holy Cross counselor, made it clear the sense of community wasn't lost between Mass and the classroom.
I think it's nice because sometimes kids are a little more hesitant to open up to people. So when they're with their peers and in a healthy environment where they can open up, they can share their ideas easier. And I think that's really awesome.
These young adults also said that social activities weren't the only reason they felt engaged with their faith through Life Teen Group. Victoria Gambaroni is a lector at St. Agnes. She shared about the projects that the Life Teen Group works on outside of the church.
In the Life Teen Group, we work a lot outside the community as well and try to get more involved in the outside community. Like, we're doing blessing bags, which we're putting like toiletries, food, some necessities, and we're giving them to homeless shelters and our food pantry here.
A lifelong advocate for youth programs, Father Chris explained the importance of this ministry.
I hear people sometimes say that, you know, youth are the future of our church, and I always try to say that, you know, they're part of the church right now. But if we don't have them now, we won't have them in the future. And as we see our parishes and the demographics around the diocese shrinking and shrinking, I think it's imperative that we engage young people in the life of the church.
And the youth at St. Agnes have certainly taken Father Chris's mission and run with it. Role model young adults and a role model church. For Real to Real, I'm Hannah Green.
Looks like the parish has really found a way to build a better Catholic community through their youth ministry program, bridging the generational gap. And still to come on Real to Real, Mark Giza brings us up to date on this busy movie season. And a Pittsfield parish reaches out to its younger members one basket at a time. These stories and more are still to come on Real to Real.
The Chalice of Salvation, your weekly spiritual connection. I'm Passionist Brother Terrence Scanlon, your Chalice host, inviting you to take time out of your busy days and join us Sunday morning at 10. This week we welcome Father Gary Daly as our Mass presider and celebrate the second Sunday in Ordinary Time. The Chalice of Salvation, your spiritual connection, Sunday morning at 10, right here on TV 22 News.
Travel next summer with Bishop Mitchell Rozanski and Catholic Communications to Fatima, Portugal to mark the centennial of the Blessed Mother's apparitions. Departing July 17th, this 10-day pilgrimage will visit three major European Catholic heritage sites, beginning at Fatima, where you will walk in the footsteps of the three young children to whom Mary appeared a century ago. Witness firsthand the great faith of the Portuguese people and the beauty of the land. See how Mary's message still inspires. From there, we'll head to Santiago de Compostela, Spain, where the remains of St. James are buried. Mass will be celebrated in the magnificent cathedral, taking in the sights and sounds of beautiful northern Spain. Our journey will conclude in Lourdes, France, Europe's other great Marian shrine, where the faith has been celebrated for over 150 years. Each day, Bishop Rozanski, assisted by Father Gary Daly, will offer Mass. For more information on this trip, log on to iobserve.org or call 413-452-0670 for a brochure. Renew your faith in 2017. Join Bishop Rozanski and Father Daly for this great spiritual opportunity. Don't miss out.
What have you done for your marriage today?
I took the baby while she worked.
Today we've actually organized a date night tonight.
I got up with the baby while he slept.
Yeah.
What have I done for my marriage today?
That is a great question.
I have carried my wife's purse.
Boy, I gave a huge hug this morning, like a really big squeeze.
We're going to the museums as a family.
What have you done for your marriage today? Don't forget the small stuff. Need ideas? Go to foryourmarriage.org, a message from the Catholic Church.
I'm Dan Dumas with your Real to Real News Brief. Well, the Christmas season came to an end on Monday with the Feast of the Baptism of the Lord, an occasion which also marks the baptism of a number of babies in the Sistine Chapel. There, Pope Francis shared some down-to-earth comments with the parents gathered.
È incominciato il concerto. È perché i bambini si trovano in un posto che non conoscono, sono alzati prima del solito forse. Incomincia uno dalla nota e poi gli altri scimmiotano e tutti si fanno. E alcuni piangono semplicemente perché ha pianto l'altro e Gesù ha fatto lo stesso. A me piace pensare che la prima predica di Gesù nella stalla è stato un pianto. La prima. E poi, come la cerimonia è un po' lunga, qualcuno piange di fame. Se è così, a voi mamme, allattateli. Senza paura, con tutta normalità, come la Madonna allattava Gesù. E non dimenticare, avete chiesto la fede, a voi il compito di custodire la fede, farla crescere, che sia testimonianza per tutti noi, anche per noi, preti, sacerdoti, vescovi, tutti. Grazie.
Meanwhile, St. Mary in Westfield hosted another in its series of Theology Untapped evenings for young adults. Kathleen Harrington reports.
Welcome to the Hangar. Welcome to Theology Untapped.
On a Thursday night in an upper room at a Westfield restaurant, a small group gathered for the latest installment of Theology Untapped. Sponsored by St. Mary's Church, this night the discussion is called Sin, Sex, and Salvation.
I actually got the title from a song lyric, if you must know.
Christopher Kloft, an associate professor at Assumption College, is the guest speaker. Filling the tables and chairs, about 50 people have turned out to enjoy drinks and appetizers, drawn to hear more about the intriguing topic.
But tonight I want to focus on divine law instead, which is another matter entirely. Divine law is what has God revealed to us? What has God said to us that we can draw moral truth from?
The Catechism of the Catholic Church perplexes people. This casual setting is meant to make the conversation more comfortable. Kloft describes the Bible as a love story involving unfaithful mankind and a God that pursues us relentlessly.
And so he becomes one of us so that he can show just how much he loves us.
But as the questions begin, it's clear the headlines about gender identity and sexual attraction prove to be confusing for many Catholics. Kloft says, don't let culture educate your children about sexuality. As a parent, he knows when the time comes, he'll face the tough questions from his own sons.
I'm going to have a conversation with them about why, as Catholics, we understand the truth to be this and why that this makes sense according to reason, the thing I didn't do tonight, and allow them to be formed by that.
St. Mary's Director of Religious Education, Joanne Baggy, hears the questions come up in CCD classes. Without getting into difficult teachings, she relies on a faith-filled answer.
There's a fine line between love and mercy and righteous indignation. But we always have to go with the side of love and mercy.
Lucas Castro was invited by friends to the evening's discussion. He calls it a borderline, never-ending subject.
I definitely expected a lot of questions to be left unanswered.
And that's why St. Mary's Parish will continue to host Theology on Tap. I'm Kathy Harrington.
And the next Theology on Tap is tentatively scheduled for Tuesday, February 21st. You can call St. Mary's Parish in Westfield for more information at 413-562-5477. That's 413-562-5477. Finally, we on Reel to Reel were saddened to learn of the passing of Detective Stephen McDonald, the New York City police officer who was paralyzed from the neck down after being shot in the line of duty 30 years ago. Detective McDonald famously forgave his teenage assailant and went on to become a prophetic voice for forgiveness and reconciliation. In July of 1986, during a period of random violence in New York City, Officer McDonald was questioning three boys. He bent down to look at what he thought was a gun in the younger boy's sock. At that moment, the oldest boy pulled a pistol and shot McDonald three times. McDonald was featured twice on Reel to Reel, the first in 2000 in New York City.
I want to free myself of any difficult emotions I had, anger, bitterness, hatred, so I could be free to love my wife and son more completely, to be a better human being, a better police officer.
Through the years, his spirit of love and forgiveness never diminished. The detective spoke 8 years later at a meeting of the Springfield chapter of Legatus.
I believe God inspired me to love the boy who shot me, to forgive the boy who shot me. And the reason I tell the story today is to help anyone, especially the young people, with the violence in their lives, to know that there's a better way forward than responding to violence with more violence. And that's with Christ-like love.
Detective McDonald died Tuesday, January 10th in Manhasset, New York. He had suffered a heart attack 4 days earlier. He was 59 years old, and he leaves his wife, Patricia, and his son, Connor, who is a sergeant with the New York Police Department. Our thoughts and prayers are with his family. And remember, you can always stay informed on all the happenings in the Catholic Church locally and beyond by logging on to our news and information website, iobserve.org. There you can read articles written by our Catholic communication staff, as well as view archived episodes of Reel to Reel. That's iobserve.org. I'm Dan Dumas, and that's your Reel to Reel News Brief.
Academy Award nominee Michael Keaton becomes the founder, The Lion Will Break Your Heart, and Ben Affleck tries to be a gangster. Let's take a look at this week's Real Culture. Lion. This is a great film, pure and simple. The true story of a young boy who is separated from his family at a young age and then gives his all to see them again will have you cheering from your seat. The cast is stellar. Oscar winner Nicole Kidman has one scene that will get her another Oscar nomination. She is true and brave. Rooney Mara is perfect as the girlfriend who is always there. And finally, Dev Patel, as the young man on this amazing journey, will take you so many places. Get ready for a film to love. And I mean love.
Can you imagine the pain they must be in not knowing where I am? Huh? 25 years, Luce. 25!
The Founder. This was a film that was slow at times for me, but I felt it was still worth watching. Michael Keaton, as always, gives a very strong performance as Ray Kroc, the famous name behind the McDonald's restaurants. I don't want to give the story away, but I was surprised on some of the details of this true story, which it was based. Overall, it was an interesting look into the lives of many people that helped to make McDonald's company what it is today. I will say, though, I was a bit disheartened in seeing how Mr. Kroc developed this billion-dollar company.
You have a contract.
You know, contracts are like hearts. They're made to be broken.
And finally, don't waste your money on Ben Affleck's new film, Live by Night. This movie about a gangster trying to be top dog is a messy, unfocused film. Yes, the film has a great look, and yes, the actors are fine. The problem is, it's boring, and there are so many great films out there to see. Don't waste a cent on this bomb.
Give us the money.
I want to be a gangster.
And you can see my reviews, as well as read other movie reviews provided by the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops online at iobserve.org. That's iobserve.org. And now for the theater, some terrific theater playing right in our area. At the Majestic Theater in West Springfield is the fantastic Tony Award-winning play Amadeus, based on the life of Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. It has fantastic actors and fantastic costumes. And opening this Tuesday at the Bushnell Theater in Hartford, Connecticut is the beautiful musical, Beautiful, based on the life of Carol King. I'm Mark Giza for Real Culture, and we'll see you at the movies.
And finally today, St. Mark's Parish in Pittsfield welcomed two hoop superstars, holding a basketball skills clinic for young people in their religious education program. As John Thornton tells us now, the students learned a lot about the sport, their faith, and life.
On the morning of Saturday, January 7th, a large group of students gathered at Taconic High School in Pittsfield to shoot some hoops with real-life Harlem superstars. Kevin Showboat Jackson, and Kenny Blenda Rodriguez, offered basketball skills clinics for children, and performed some signature tricks with music provided by DJ Master of Sounds Eddie Brown. Kenny Blenda Rodriguez, a native of Washington Heights, New York, described what the event meant to him.
Today is all about having a great, fun, an iconic moment with these wonderful kids. We're just trying to build long-lasting memories that'll last a lifetime, and to also give them the knowledge of a basketball camp and a clinic to showcase what we do on the court and off the court. So a lot of things that we do is we try to improve the kids' basketball skill level and also try to give a positive message and just overall have some music to get the kids motivated and just have a blast with them and have an awesome time, because me and Showboat Jackson, we just love the kids and we always love to give back to the community. And it's all about just having fun, having a good time.
The event was put on by St. Mark's Parish Community Outreach Program. The administrator of St. Mark's Parish, Father David Offiero, explained how he met Harlem superstar Kevin Showboat Jackson.
Back in October, the Dominican sisters from Hartford, Connecticut, they were selling bread in my parish. And they sent up Kevin Showboat Jackson, and I had no idea who he was, but we were setting up outside my church for the bread that the sisters wanted, and we did all that, and we got to talking, and he was telling me about all the great camps that he was doing and all the great things that he was doing with youth.
I spoke to Father David Offiero of St. Mark's Parish in Pittsfield and asked him how faith and sports play a role in the lives of young people.
Well, I think that faith and sports can definitely come together, because on the sports field, we kind of grow as a person. We learn how to win graciously, we learn how to lose graciously, and today's just all about faith, family, and a friendly game of basketball and some great entertainment as well. I've met some really great people on the basketball court, people who I've asked on my finance council to be the head of my finance council that I play basketball with, and so you never know who you're gonna meet. And the people that I play with, usually they have a connection to the youth programs and they wanna do everything that they can to empower the youth. You can teach faith and morals through the game of basketball by teaching people how to be, you know, good winners, good losers, like I said, and that hopefully that would translate into being good citizens as well.
The Harlem superstars don't just entertain children and work with them in their basketball skills. They also give them a positive message about life. Kenny Rodriguez elaborated on his message for today's youth.
My message to the kids is to always believe in yourself, because you can accomplish anything that you want in life. It don't matter the height, the skill level. You can become anything that you put your mind to. If you want to become a teacher, you can do that. If you want to become an actor, you can do that. Just surround yourself around positive people and everything is going to turn out all right.
While not definite, there are plans in the works to have the Harlem Superstars return to the area next year. In Pittsfield, I'm John Thornton.
Well, that wraps things up here on Reel to Reel. Thanks so much for making us a part of your day. And if you'd like to travel with Father Gary Daly and Springfield Bishop Mitchell Rozanski to Portugal, Spain, and France next July, there are still seats available. But the registration date to get a special discount expires this week. For more information, check out a link we have on iobserve.org, or we can send you more information in the mail. Just call 413-732-3175. That's 413-732-3175. As always, to keep up with all of the latest news on the Catholic Church, both here in the Diocese of Springfield and around the world, check out our news and information website, iobserve.org. There you will find stories posted and updated throughout the day, and a link to full past episodes of Reel to Reel and segments that we have shared. For accurate news on the Catholic faith, there is only one local source, that's iobserve.org. And to get news alerts, you can friend us on Facebook. We are at Catholic Communications. I will see you next week at this same time for another edition of Reel to Reel, your window on the world around you. Have a great week.
Reel to Reel is a production of the Catholic Communications Corporation, funded in part by the annual Catholic Appeal and the support of you, our faithful viewers,